I don't know. I just saw a giant ball roll down. This is gonna be good. He who sets foot in the shrine, I'm Oa Dime. In the name of the goddess Hylea, I offer this trial. Because surely they're not going to give me a new power every time I do one of these things. I'm assuming there's a lot of them. I feel like I recall them saying there were going to be an awful lot of them, actually. Stasis. Stop the flow of time for an object. Stops an object time or storing its kinetic energy. Stored energy will act upon the object and the flow of time resumes. Make good use of stored energy can move even the largest of objects. Alright. Being able to freeze things sounds overpowered. Stasis, alright. Oh, I have to freeze the yellow things. So you get a good 10 seconds out of that. You can't spam it. Which is good. I feel like that would be a little unfair. So we're definitely gonna need it here. I don't know, we could... Oh yeah! How do you like that? Don't even have to use the power. Oh, I thought my rock was cool. Guess not. Let's get rid of some of these crappy melee weapons. Again. I mean, I'm sure these great spears will be super useful. This thing's damaged. No, that's not it. How do I get rid of... Like, is there an easy way to get rid of things? Hold on. Remove, drop... Yeah. There we go. So it said you can move the largest of things with it. Woo! Oh, I see a secret treasure chest over there. We're gonna definitely have to get that. So basically, you can... You can apply force to it. That's why they gave us the weapon. You know, I wasn't supposed to break my sword for that. You can apply force to it, and then it will stick. Oh! Help! 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 The rock is very powerful. Let's see. I got some good food for this. Look at all those animations he's got. That rock took a while to come down. I was waiting for it, and then when I let down my guard, it didn't. Traveler's Shield. Not really much better, but it is arguably slightly better. Let's get rid of at least the pot lid. That sucks. That's actually... Okay, I gotta say... So far, all of their abilities have been pretty spot-on amazing. That magnetic one is pretty cool. The frozen block one, I think it'll at least be useful, if nothing else. And this one is pretty cool as well. Oh, that's how we get the rock off outside. We freeze time, we hit it a bunch, and then we get rid of the rock. Your resourcefulness in overcoming this trial speaks to the promise of a hero. In the name of Goddess Hylea, I bestow upon you the Spirit Orb. Goddess smile upon you. See, they sell skeletal stall monsters like they're scary. They're pretty easy. They're like a one hit, and then you hit them again to make sure they don't come back. And they spawn in twos. There's like two of them. That's it. Alright, so, freeze time, beat the crap out of this rock, and off into the great beyond it goes. That is a non-playable area, so yeah, it's gone. That's actually a really cool mechanic. Oh man, can you think of like the crazy stuff you'd be able to do against enemies? I'm just thinking about it now, right? You line it up so that, you know, enemies are going to be in the way. And you just absolutely destroy them. This is a good one. Knocking into a crowd of enemies. You might even be able to freeze enemies, too. It does seem another one of those, like, you can only do it on the things that they tell you you can do it on. But I think it might still be useful. Is it cold over here again? Get me out of this cold wasteland. I don't want to be in it. I might have to use an item anyway. Okay, that's fine. Is that the shrine there? Is that something on fire? I think that's the shrine. Hold on. That is the shrine. Okay. Well, I mean, I'm gonna try it. If I run out of stamina, I will take one of my stamina foods. Don't press the jump button. Don't pass go, do not collect 200. Here, we are going to try... Let's try that one. Alright, cool. So you can't eat them while climbing. That's probably a very important usage of them. I can already tell cooking's going to be a very important part of this game. Okay, so we are going to run out of stamina. Hopefully we are close enough to the ground where it will not kill us. Let's see. Oh, wow. Yeah. That sort of worked. We only accidentally stumbled upon an enemy camp. Oh, triple kill! Oh, bees! This seems dangerous. It's all gonna be worth it. It's all gonna be worth it. It's all gonna be worth it. At least they're inaccurate. You know, the more I think about it, the better this seems like a really good stream game. Because there's a lot of stuff to do in it, but, like, I can't necessarily say that by the time I finish all this up, I'm going to have achieved anything. I mean, I will have. I'll have gotten to all of the trials and probably some more. Because I've been going for a little over an hour now. Throwing spear. That looks better than the piece of crap sticks that I've had up until now. What's a sadistic guy doing with all these... Oh, what happened to my honey? Did I walk away too far from it? I think I did. Ooh, bomb arrows. Oh, that looks useful. How does that fit? Oh, I get a new slot for that. Okay. So, that's useful for maybe if I'm fighting something really big and I need to, you know, do some damage. Or possibly... Oh, I could have done all sorts of cool things. I have a feeling this is more just gonna, like, break into pieces when it unfreezes. No, it got launched. What are these? Rush room. Temporarily increase your movement speed. I would in fact like to temporarily increase my movement speed. That sounds good. I think I saw another one. This looks almost like a house. Don't immediately sense any enemies. Looks a lot more civilized than the bobble ones. And they have a pot lid. An excellent weapon. Oh boy. Lore? Maybe lore. The old man's diary that I read while standing on his table. On this desolate plateau, the only pleasure that brings me comfort is cooking. And today I outdid myself. Truly, I created the perfect dish. I call it spicy meat and seafood fry. The recipe not only restores health, but also keeps me warm, even when traveling in the snowy mountains. With this dish on my side, I no longer have need of that itchy, warm doublet. Doublet? I do not know how I allowed this to happen, but it seems I forgot to write down a very important recipe. I know it contained raw meat and spicy pepper, however. Simply cannot remember what else I used. My age is catching up to me. I imagine the sea bass, or not the bass, the Hylea bass or whatever. You'd happily reward them with your doublet? You would reward someone with your doublet if... Who knew the missing ingredient? So maybe I need to try to do that. Let's try that really quick, just to see if I can learn that. Whoops, not quite. So, what was it? It was spicy pepper. I think it's a bass. And what was the other one? Oh, it was meat, which I don't have. So, I probably need to get some meat before I can do that. Was that the old man? I think it is. Wait, I was gonna say birds have meat. They're made of meat. Birds are made of meat. So are lizards that hide in holes. Okay, now I'm dedicated to finding this recipe. Maybe if we're lucky, the birds will come back. But I kind of have a feeling that birds aren't that dumb. You know, they get scared by something, they usually don't come back. Not unless they're, you know, in a parking lot. Then they'll do that sometimes. Oh, it's you! Oh, fancy that. So we meet again. What are you doing? I thought this tree here might make for some good firewood. However, getting a tree to fall exactly where you want it to is quite an art. The trick is to turn your hips so that they face where you want the tree to land. So you found my axe. Why not help me out and give it a few swings? I'm working up quite a sweat here, but these bones could use a break. So I do remember this thing, that there is a mechanic where I think you can use trees to, like, bridge gaps. If you, you know, have an axe. So you said, align your hips to where you want it to fall. No, it just falls right in front of you. That's... Yeah, just like that. And now you can... carefully, very carefully... walk along the log bridge. It's a neat mechanic. I like it. Stupid squirrel. You're made out of meat, too. Oh, you've got our acorns. Probably shouldn't try to launch him off a cliff if I'm hoping to get... whatever juicy treasures that they have. Sure, let's use the club. What are they guarding? That looks destructible. And you know, normally I wouldn't have a way to get in here, but I did just get those bomb arrows. Hey, there you go. Fire arrows. Nice. I don't know. It might have been arguably worth it. Give me your apples, tree. Oh, this is kind of cool. So it's not as effective as an axe. But bladed weapons can be used to cut down trees, it seems. With an axe being much better because it fells it in like two swipes. And, you know, blunt weapons being understandably completely unuseful. Alright, so, I still need to get that. That's alright. I've got another sledgehammer. I don't want too many of the same thing. I also need to stop accidentally pressing the whistle button when I'm near enemies trying to be stealthy. That would be another good thing to not do. What is it? What are you doing? This body of mine isn't what it used to be. Recovering from a bout of hard work takes a while. If you're hungry, I have an empty pot you can use to cook yourself a meal. I cooked something. I did? Oh. Let's take a look at what you cooked up there, shall we? Not bad. Certainly not good, but not bad either. In case you're wondering, I know you were poking around in my diary. That said, if you do end up figuring out how to create that dish I wrote about, that warm doublet is all yours. If it's raw meat you're after, try hunting in the Forest of Spirits. You'll find it in the northern part of the plateau. Well, he sort of answered my question. Northern part of the plateau. Oh, up there. Yeah, I mean, if I could get one of those birds again, that would be totally, like, all I'd need. Gotta be on the lookout for him. Unless, of course, they want me just to use the, that, you know, that one creature, whatever it was. Okay, let's try for this bird. Like the boar-looking thing. Maybe if I'm lucky, bird might be what I need. I mean, he says seafood, right? One would only assume the only kind of, you know, fish of anything that I've seen would be what you'd need. And the pepper. Let's try it. Well, it's not a failure. Spicy meat and seafood fry. I think that might be it. Wait, is that? That looks just like my signature perfect dish. Spicy meat and seafood fry. But how did you... Well, I suppose that's not important. Can I trouble you to share the recipe? Huh? Ah, of course, Hyrule Bass. How could I have forgotten? Well done. Now please allow me to reward your culinary efforts with this warm doublet. Oh, it's a piece of clothing. Gotcha. I was wondering what it was. I didn't recognize what that was. With that, you'll be able to resist the bite of colder environments. As for me, I know a great spicy meat and seafood fry recipe, so I can do without that warm doublet. Alright, so that gives me cold resistance. It wouldn't give me any better, it wouldn't give me anything better in terms of armor, but it's, you know, good for cold. I do get very toasty near the fire with it. So, I'm assuming due to the fact that I haven't had any issues yet with any of my clothes breaking, even though I have taken a decent chunk of damage, that armor and stuff probably doesn't break. Or at least clothing maybe doesn't break. Maybe armor does. Anyway, let's cook some more stuff. Because I have been munching through food just for the, you know, the side effects that they've been giving. I don't know, spicy apple, that's gotta be good, right? Spicy simmered fruit. Yum. Alright, the ultimate spicy dish. Yeah, lots of them. I wish there'd be a way to... I guess it doesn't matter later on in the game. It's more of an early game problem. But for you to not take so long to make all this food... Oh yeah, let's cook both of these. That should make me faster. For 2 minutes. Alright. Oh yeah, let's cook up... I don't know. So, ideally this would just give me a ton of stamina back. Like, probably a whole bar of it. Oh, that gives me part of another stamina wheel. I have a feeling that that's not going to benefit me a ton yet. Yeah. I also have a distinct feeling that if I ever really need stamina, I'm probably not going to need a bunch of health restorative benefits to it, so I probably shouldn't really cook anything else with these mushrooms. I'm just saying, if you start mixing it with other stuff, it doesn't seem that useful. Problem is, skipping it doesn't really save much time. I skip and save like maybe a second, if that. Alright, so, back to what I was doing. The Eastern Abbey. Seems fairly okay this way, nothing... I mean, there's some enemies, but, you know, no massive cold areas or anything. Still have to worry about stamina, but it does make me faster. Oh gosh, I hear bees. Give me your honey. Give me the honey. I just want the honey. Cooking this meal unlocks the potential of these nutrients. Stamina recovery. Now we run away from bees, because bees are scary. Or we hit them with an axe, because that's... you can do that, I guess. I mean, I'm sure you could hit bees with an axe, but I feel like, as a whole, it would be a largely fruitless endeavor. Well, you're not dead yet. There you go. Ooh, slow down. Slow down, please. Still enjoying the game, but man, I think it's this grass effect here that's slowing it down. That's the other thing that I learned after a bit of research, is that apparently both the Switch and the Wii U version of the game lag. And they do so in different places, apparently. It's not just a single area where the game will lag for either of them. You know, it'll happen to both of the games. So if you're looking to avoid lag, you can't really avoid it in either of the situations. Though, like I've been told, if you run the game in 720p, apparently pretty much it doesn't have any lag problems. Which you can do either by forcing it to... by forcing the console to run in 720p, or you can also, you could also, if you run it in tablet mode, you know, like, undocked, it will, it'll run in 720p as well, because that's what the tablet screen is. Oh, yeah, these things. Should be loads of fun. Ooh! So, don't take a direct hit from the laser beam! Now that's Dark Souls right there. They don't even give you, like, a shot to figure out that it hurts. They just waste you. It's best to avoid these foes until you have the right tool for the job. I wonder if I could hit it in its eye. The eye seems like a weak point. Let's try. Even the shield didn't do anything, it just melted through the shield. That was crazy damage. Pick up. Pick up. I'll vanquish my foe with a rock. Well, that stuns him temporarily, if nothing else. Alright, so they have a maximum range. And I should probably be careful. I'm sure bomb arrows would be somewhat effective on them, but it seems slightly wasteful. Does that fire ever go out? Okay. We could have climbed the wall, or apparently this was a option as well, was just to blow up the gate. It's hard to believe I've only been playing for an hour and a half. I haven't done much. I mean, I've done a lot, sure, but I'm only now on the third shrine. And the shrines themselves are pretty short. They take you like 5 minutes, if that. Sometimes even like 3 minutes to complete. Most of your time is spent traversing between them. Isn't a bad thing, I'd say. I like these shorter, more contained events. That's the other thing I was thinking about, is that I'm not currently interested in the Switch as a portable console. Ooh, bomb trial. Are we gonna get bombs? I'm not currently interested in the Switch as a portable console. However, if they introduce like the virtual console stuff again, which I'm almost sure they will, especially if I can recover some of my virtual console stuff I got for on like the Wii U, that would be super cool, and I might actually be interested in carrying it around as like a, you know, as a portable console rather than just a home console, which is what I'm using it for right now. Remote bomb. Bomb that can be detonated remotely. Thanks. Looks like you got something else as well. They're both round and cube bombs. Ooh! And that's a rune, not like an ability. So do I, in fact, have unlimited bombs? Keep pressing the wrong one. Alright, so it's time-based, but it does appear like you would have unlimited bombs like this. So I would assume square bombs are useful for... They act like a square, they won't roll around. The circular ones will roll, which either of them could be useful in the right situation. Square if you don't want it to roll. If you... Wow, look at that. If you do in fact want it to roll though, I could see it being very useful. Link, well, that's a nice claymore. I'm gonna have to get used to it. When they tell me L, they mean the bumper, not the trigger. Okay, yeah, I'm seeing what they want you to do here. And of course, I imagine these bombs to be very useful when fighting enemies. We are to launch a bomb, perhaps? Or ourselves, if we so choose. That's actually probably what we want to do to get that chest. What are you? I think you're just supposed to... kind of generally show me how this whole thing works. Okay, that was not the right way to go about that. Ah! There you go. These bonus chests always seem to not be the greatest of treasures. Now here's some arrows. Here's some of this, here's some of that, though I guess I can't complain too much about arrows, they're kind of cool. Okay, so this would lead me to believe that they want me to use a circular bomb. Oh, right, I left a circular bomb back there. So you can have both a circular and a square bomb at different locations if you, you know, feel like it, I guess. These rune bombs are weird. I like them, though. They're more just like tutorials for how to use this new item you got. Which I know that's what they set them up on purpose for, and then later on you can use them out in the field in fun different ways. I'm very resourceful, I can blow things up. So that should be the last one. The old man should be chill with us now. Goddess smile upon you. I still like stasis more, but blowing things up is always cool. And, you know, I'm pretty sure that'll have uses further on as well. Wonder if I can use the bombs on the guardian guys. I bet those would be pretty powerful against him. With this, you've now acquired all of the spirit orbs from the shrines in this plateau. Ho-ho, extraordinary. That means it's finally time. Link, it's finally time for me to tell you everything. But first... imagine an X on your map with the four shrines as the endpoints. Find the spot where those lines intersect. I shall wait for you there. But what about the paraglider? What about the paraglider? Old man? Alright. So draw an X between the four shrines. Well, they don't perfectly line up, but it looks like he wants me to meet him at the Temple of Time. Can't help but notice there's like northern lights over there. That looks cool. I'd like to visit that at some point. Alright, so this guardian thing. No! No! Bob, what are you doing? It's time to move! So it does do damage. Holy crap, that is powerful. I don't know if I got quite like a spot-on hit with it, though. Getting a bit better at making that land right. It's all just the bumpers. That's all this is.
Ha!
Kind of hard to fight with, though, if you're fighting anything moving like this, especially because I'm trying to stay behind cover at the moment. Yeah, I'm gonna say that's probably not the best way to go about that. Alright, so... it'd probably be best just to travel from the Shrine of Resurrection, though this would give us another chance to see the map from a different angle. So, I think we're just gonna dash out of here. Ooh! I'm on fire! Ow! That hurts. That's a good one. Sure do love me some guardians. Yeah, right there. That's where he wants to meet us at. And this is where I fought some guys, I remember. This guy almost wrecked me. Looks like they're not there anymore, though. I am a little bit worried that... if enemies never end up coming back, it might make the world kind of a bit dull. Even low-level enemies, they're kind of fun just to, you know, beat up every once in a while. But that being said, it might not be too bad. Let's see if I can jump this. Because, you know, this is very obviously supposed to be a kind of tutorial-ish section. And so it's very possible that we may never end up coming back up here again for quite some time. So I have a feeling he wants to meet us up at the big one that had the statues in it. I'm seeing some glowing lights in here. I think I might be right. Maybe. Maybe not. Maybe the glowing lights were completely... had nothing to do with this. Oh, you have conquered the shrines and claimed their spirit orbs. I offer you great power. It appears you've claimed 4 spirit orbs. In exchange for 4 spirit orbs, I'll amplify your being. So tell me what it is you desire. Ah, so this is how you get hearts in this game. I think I heard there's some you get with just heart containers, but I think you get a lot of them this way as well. So I could either get another heart container, bringing me up to 4, or I get another stamina vessel so I could run and climb for longer. Stamina? I don't know if it's a full stamina vessel. Maybe they just give you a quarter, but... stamina kind of sounds useful. I don't know. Ooh. Though then again, I have been getting hit with a lot of things that have been leaving me with like a quarter heart left, so maybe another heart container might be nice. I think we're going to do heart container this time, but I'll stamina next one. I shall grant the power you seek. Hand delivered. So nice. Life force has been strengthened. Go and bring peace to Hyrule. Alright, cool. So I should definitely be collecting those when I can, then. And that was what I was supposed to do. The blessing of the goddess has made you that much more resilient, I see. Here I am. Get up here quickly. Should have gone for the stamina gauge. Would have been much easier. Alright. That's fine. Yeah, the stamina gauge does run out pretty quickly because you are intended to upgrade it. Oh, except this is a ladder, so this is a much easier way to get up. This would be cool and all, except for the fact that I already did climb up here by myself. Oh well.
Well done there, young one.
Ooh, voice acting. Now then,
the time has come to show you who I truly am. I was King Rome Bosphoramus Hyrule. I was the last leader of Hyrule. A kingdom which no longer exists.
Oh. I mean, that's cool.
The Great Calamity was merciless. It devastated everything in its path, Lo, a century ago. It was then that my life was taken away from me. And since that time, here I have remained in spirit form. I did not think it wise to overwhelm you while your memory was still fragile. So rather than that, I thought it best to assume a temporary form. Forgive me. I think you are now ready. Ready to hear what happened 100 years ago.
I thought you meant ready to go take on the evil Calamity, because I got 4 hearts, dude. That's not going to happen.
True form. One must know the story from an age long past. The Demon King was born into this kingdom, but his transformation into malice created the horror you see now. Stories of Ganon were passed from generation to generation in the form of legends and fairy tales. But there was also a prophecy. The signs of a resurrection of Calamity Ganon are clear, and the power to oppose it lies dormant beneath the ground. We decided to heed the prophecy and began excavating large areas of land. It wasn't long before we discovered several ancient relics made by the hands of our distant ancestors. These relics, the divine beasts, were giant machines piloted by warriors. We also found the Guardians, an army of mechanical soldiers who fought autonomously. This coincided with ancient legends, oft repeated throughout our land. We also learned of a princess with a sacred power, and her appointed knight, chosen by the sword that seals the darkness. It was they who sealed Ganon away using the power of these ancient relics. 100 years ago, there was a princess set to inherit a sacred power, and a skilled knight at her side. It was clear that we must follow our ancestors' path. We selected 4 skilled individuals from across Hyrule and tasked them with the duty of piloting the divine beasts. With the princess as their commander, we dubbed these pilots champions, a name that would solidify their unique bond. The princess, her appointed knight, and the rest of the champions were on the brink of sealing away Ganon. But nay. Ganon was cunning, and he responded with a plan beyond our imagining.
Guys like laser beams.
He appeared from deep below Hyrule Castle, seized control of the Guardians and the Divine Beasts, and turned them against us. The champions lost their lives, those residing in the castle as well. The appointed knight, gravely wounded, collapsed while defending the princess. And thus, the kingdom of Hyrule was devastated absolutely by Calamity Ganon. However, the princess survived to face Ganon alone.
Link, you are our final hope. The fate of Hyrule rests with you.
princess was my own daughter, my dear Zelda. And the courageous knight who protected her right up to the very end. That knight was none other than you, Link. You fought valiantly when your fate took an unfortunate turn. And then, you were taken to the Shrine of Resurrection. Here you now stand, revitalized 100 years later. The words of guidance you have been hearing since your awakening are from Princess Zelda herself. Even now, as she works to restrain Ganon from within Hyrule Castle, she calls out for your help. However, my daughter's power will soon be exhausted. Once that happens, Ganon will freely regenerate himself, and nothing will stop him from consuming our land. Considering that I could not save my own kingdom, I have no right to ask this of you, Link. But I am powerless here. You must save her, my daughter, and do whatever it takes to annihilate Ganon. Somehow, Ganon has maintained control over all four divine beasts, as well as those guardians swarming around Hyrule Castle. I believe it would be quite reckless for you to head directly to the castle at this point. I suggest that you make your way east out to one of the villages in the wilderness. Follow the road out to Kakariko Village. There you will find the Elder Impa.
Impa?
She will tell you more about the path that lies ahead.
Oh boy.
Consult the map on your Sheikah slate for the precise location of Kakariko Village. Make your way past the twin summits of the dueling peaks. From there, follow the road as it proceeds north.
So, do I get the cool hang glider thing now?
Hmm.
Yes, there we go. Here's the paraglider, just as I promised. An item you received from the king on the Great Plateau allows you to sail through the sky. Press X while you're in the air to use it. With that, you should be able to safely fly off the cliffs surrounding this area. And I think that's it. I've told you everything I can. Link, you must save Hyrule. Destroy Ganon. But don't head straight for Ganon, because that's how you die. Did you notice that? My objective was set straight for the castle for a second, but now it's set over here. Alright, so they want me to head way out here. I think he said something about the dueling peaks. Whoops, let's... No. Which I think those are the dueling peaks. So we can probably get a map if we head towards that tower. Alright, the moment I've been waiting for. Okay, that didn't quite work out the way I wanted it to. Oh, it takes stamina to fly. I didn't think holding on would be that difficult of a task. I don't know. I guess it is. Maybe a running jump would have been a better option, you know? But you can use it, like, any time, so that's kind of cool, I guess. You know, I didn't even think about that. I was thinking about it now. You know, I was thinking about fighting these guys. But I bet there's an even easier option I could have dealt with them. I could have stasis them. I bet. Let me try really quick. See if this guy's moving. Not that guy. Oh, you guys again. Prepare to get claymored. Ow! I gotta try it, okay? Just bear with me for a moment. Okay, never mind. Tragic error has been made. Quick, let's get out of here. Just let go if you run out of stamina? I hope not. Seems a little devastated out here. So many interesting landmarks. It's so fun just to run around and look at everything. Oh. For some reason, these feel like burial sites. I don't know. Don't know what that's for. Is there some puzzle here? Wait, hold on. Hey. Got a numbers puzzle. Hey, it's you, little wood folk! You found me! Huh? You're not Hetsu. Or Hestu, but you can see me? I didn't know your kind could see the children of the forest. Well, if you run into Hestu, please return this to him. Korok seed. You gather a bunch of them, you never know what may happen. Oh, my friends are hiding in lots of different places, too. Don't be shy about poking your nose into suspicious places. Alright. Glad we met, small creature.